Hey guys, AJ Gemya here, and welcome to my channel. Now, today, this is going to be the third episode in my new series, ExoZombie Challenge, where, basically, the hint is in the name. I'm going to be doing a different challenge in each episode, which, whatever you want me to do, write down in the comment section below. It can be anything from don't use any perks, see how far you can survive, only use a pistol, only use one particular gun, or only use the first gun you either purchase off the walls or the first gun you get out of the mystery box. It could be use no perks, don't use the exo suit, no melee only, although with that I really highly doubt I'd get probably past level 10, I would imagine. But if you guys want that, I'll give it a go. So today, I'm thinking I'm going to use the first weapon I get out of the mystery box. And I can't use any other weapons. So that's the first gun I get out of the mystery box, or 3D printer, as I believe it's called in this game. First gun I get is the only gun I can use until I die, until it's over. So hopefully we can do quite well today. I think because this is the first episode as well, I'm going to go all guns blazing. I'm not going to use perks either. So the first gun I get out of the mystery box or 3D printer, and no perks. I'm going to see how far I can get, how many rounds I can survive. Alright, let's see where we can go now.
Shit. Need more rounds. Fuck it.
Right, we've got 3 bullets left. And okay, we're now out of bullets. Can only use melee until I can afford to open the door. I must admit, though, I really do enjoy this game mode. I think Sledgehammer, hats off to them, have done an excellent job. Which, I know a lot of people probably like the multiplayer in this game. And I'm not going to insult those of you that do like it. But for me, I really, really don't like the multiplayer in this game. It's not the exosuits, it's just, for me, the lag. Or skill-based matchmaking, whatever it is you want to call it. For me, because I'm on a wired internet connection, it's just terrible. You're getting shot around corners, rubber banding, or whatever else people seem to call it. But the zombies, they really did do a good job. Considering for me the multiplayer, they could have absolutely ruined this zombie mode. I mean, although it is basically, if you haven't got this game mode, it's more like Black Ops 2 zombies than it is the World at War or Black Ops 1 zombies. And for those of you who have played the old zombies on any of the older games, I would say this is, it's on the scale of Black Ops 2, not so much the World at War or Black Ops 1 zombies. Certainly not better than the World at War or Black Ops 1 zombies anyway. So here we go. Obviously, as you've just seen, this is the first gun now, the IMR, that I got out of the 3D printer box. And it's the only gun now I can use. I am allowed to upgrade it. Well, in this video anyway. I don't know what challenges you guys might come up with, but I can upgrade it. But I cannot purchase any other weapons. So if I run out of ammo, the only chance is getting max ammo here, or full reload as it's called in this game, or by upgrading it. So I'm going to have to use my upgrades scarcely, I think. But I want to know what you guys think of this ExoZombies. Because I know a lot of people, they're on the fence about it. A lot of people like it, a lot of people dislike it. Some people haven't really got an opinion on it. They just think it's all right, but not really much they'll say about it. But what do you guys think? Do you think it's a good substitute for the Nazi zombies that have been in the Treyarch games? Do you think it's better than the Treyarch zombies? What do you think they could use to improve this? Do you think they need bigger maps, smaller maps? I mean, personally, I always thought that the DeVries map in World at War, which I think was remade for Black Ops 1 as well, that was just about the right size for a zombie map. I think in Black Ops 2, the transit map they come out with, going down that route, personally, they made it too big. It was, not to say complicated, but too big. The fog as well, with all those creatures, it was just an absolute nightmare. I mean, I played it a bit for when it obviously first came out, because that was the only zombie map that you had, minus the little ones that sort of broke off from the bigger map. But didn't really care for it much at all. Alright, I think we're going to need to get that orbital drop in a minute. We don't get jammed now here with the power. DNA bomb. I do miss the sound effects though of these pickups that you used to get. So the sort of creepy Richthofen voice they used to be when you had the nuke or the Maxamo. I know that probably makes you sound a bit like a pervert or something, like hiding in the shadows, but I do miss those sound effects. They went well with the whole, for me, in the game, they went well with it. They sort of, they gave it a bit more of a horror aspect. It's a, you know, really creepy voice. Ooh, that was close. Really creepy voice, and it just added a bit more to the game. I mean, personally, I think the reason they've obviously done the voices like they have in this is, I mean, I haven't researched this, but I think this particular map, is it some sort of simulation for the Atlas Corporation? You know, obviously from what they have been developing, the DNA bomb and things like that, maybe they were accounting for if something like this did happen as a result of using it. Now, what led me to that conclusion, I hear you ask, is, well, first off, every time you seem to do certain things, it's what the characters say. They might come up with particular quotes or things like that, like Atlas is watching and things like that. Secondly, as you'll see here, the pickups flashing green, like a sort of, as you see in films, certain films and things, like that greeny colour that lends in with the coding and all that aspect of things. And then, as well, in terms of these pickups, it's the sound they make. You got a woman that she sort of, it's always the same voice in a the way she says it. To me, reminds me of some sort of simulation. So I don't know what you guys think about that, but that's my theory anyway. And because it seems to be very similar to the Exo Survival game mode as well, which, if obviously you look up in the air in that particular game mode, you will see like a sort of magnetic dome, a covering over the map, which obviously is some sort of simulation. And because this is quite similar with the perks and things like that, It just, to me, it makes quite a lot of sense. I mean, some of you might be thinking, what the hell is he on about? But that's what I think, anyway.
Oh, now that's nice.
Right, consider we're not buying any perks. We can upgrade this a few times now. Seems to be a one shot, but four bullet kill. Oh no. Better reload before they start charging at me again. I think not having any perks mine with this particular gun. Oh, it's gonna screw me over at times, I think. Alright, I think we're gonna need to go and get that score streak. Because with no perks and just this gun, every little helps. I know this isn't an advert for Tesco's with the their motto thrown in there. Although it could be. So Tesco's, if you're watching, if you want to do a bit of sponsoring, I'd be more than happy to use your motto. Can't see that happening in mine, but you never know. The corporate owner of Tesco's, which over here in the UK, for anyone else who's not in the UK, it's a big supermarket store. Which is, I'd say, definitely dearer than Asda's, which I think over in America you call it Walmart. It's sort of the same chain. Oh. Not a good idea. Not a good idea, guys. Just try and bring it out here, get some more space going. I do like it on this though, when you upgrade your weapon, how you get your all your different attachments and, you know, your iron sights go into red dot sights or thermal sights, or I'm not sure what they call this sight, but I know in Black Ops 2 it was like a some sort of hybrid sight that would sort of show you the enemies and highlight them. Hence the reason why the zombies appear red when I aim down the sight. Oh, what was that? Oh, this gun's gonna cause problems. This is a lot of zombies. A lot of zombies. I think I might need to go and buy a contact grenade. I think I might need to upgrade my pistol as well. I can't buy any other weapons. Bless me, guys. Well, this camouflage should definitely help out, so thank God for that. Reloading. Oh, cool. We've got an iron sight now as well. It's going to be useful. Thank God for that exploding zombie. Holy moly. Nice. Alright, let's keep these upgrades going, guys.
All the latest toys.
I don't want to upgrade them too much, though. Because I know when you get to round 20, which is the highest sort of upgrade level, unless you obviously do the Easter egg, which I believe it takes you to level 21, I think is the highest. Which gives you like a cool new camouflage and would probably make this gun quite beastie, to be fair. But I want to sort of save my upgrades. Just in case I run out of ammo. Cause it, for you guys who haven't played this game mode, every time you upgrade a gun, it does give you full ammo back. Which I know in the World at War and that, they never actually used to do that. Which was a bit of a pain, so.
Oh, shit just got real.
You always had to keep a crawler and then go out at the end of the round, try and switch out your weapons
there
and things like that. Alright, that sentry turret on the other side of the map could be a lot of use. Oh, electro zombie. I was close. That was close. Good thing about this gun, it does print its ammo as well. Which, I mean, I don't know how fast it actually does that, but it is supposed to print its own ammo. So you see the bottom right hand corner, it's now on 80. There you go, 84. So it goes up one shot every couple of seconds. Heavens. This is gonna get interesting, I think, to say the least. I think I'm gonna have to whip out the one of the score streaks, help out a little bit. As long as I don't get hit by an electric zombie, I'm hoping I'll be alright. Because that will really screw me over. Taking a lot of damage here. Yes, insta-kill. That's what we want. Double points. Alright, let's go and upgrade my gun again, guys. I think we'll upgrade the pistol then again. That's the next step. This drone doesn't seem to be doing much, mind. Because I know when I've had them online, I've played with, you know, obviously four players. It tends to shoot rockets every time I get them, so I don't know if I'm just lucky. And is there different types of them? Or can you only get the machine gun one on the single player? Well, I say single player, on you play on your own. DNA bomb. It's going to help. Credits. 400 credits. Nice. Security's gonna help as well. I'm not gonna open this door because then hopefully I can try and reduce the chaos slightly. Not by much, mind, but. Right. Round 16. Got a Mark 10 IMR and a Mark 4 Atlas pistol. No perks. And one grenade, so I do need to go and get another grenade now, I think, guys. Oh no. Oh, that's done me. Well, guys, it's not too bad. Probably could have done a hell of a lot better, but considering I was only using an IMR and a pistol, no perks, not too bad for my first episode, my first try. So thanks for watching, guys. Leave your opinions and your ideas down in the comments below what you want me to do next time. So thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.